St. James Plantation. Let's see what he has in store for us today when we tour the SeaSide and Regency Lakes model.
Hey everybody, welcome to St. James Plantation. Come on in. We're at Cottages at Sandy Cove. I want to walk you through a 1380 plan. You guys earlier had seen designers talk about their concept for finishes, texture, design intent, furnishings. We've done a little work since then. Why don't you go and check it out? We are now about 1 week and a half from moving furnishings in and putting the finishing touches on the 1380 plan. This plan is one of five that we're going to build, design, and furnish to make it easier for you to come to St. James and choose your home. This home was done by a design team, local design team, and they had a Key West feel in mind. So as you tour through the house, you can see some of the color schemes, fixtures, finishes all call to mind Key West, Tommy Bahama, and feet up in a chaise lounge on the beach. Really focused on trying to maintain an open look and feel for a lifestyle that facilitates flexibility and use in different spaces in easy, entertaining, easy day-to-day living. Paid a lot of attention to connecting the front door and eaves out to the rear covered patio, and the outdoor living spaces are tied to the indoor spaces. Each of the plans, the kitchen, dining room, and family room, all relate to one another to provide for the Thanksgiving crowd, but also the day-to-day for spreading out a newspaper and enjoying a quiet breakfast at home. Each of the plans we've designed for Cottages at Sandy Cove is available as a main floor only, or main and upstairs should you need more space. This plan as standard without the stairs facilitates a larger cook closet and a pantry that ties to the kitchen. If you decide to add the upstairs, it's about 680 additional feet. Can be bedrooms, bathrooms, any configuration you want, or just simply additional storage. Let's take a look. This is a pretty typical upstairs to each of the cottages in Sandy Cove. What we've done in this one in particular is make the space as wide open as possible to show the space that you can configure to suit your needs. This space can be anything from a wide open storage. So where we now see a half wall, this could be a full wall. Everything on this side can be left as storage. The house side stays finished and clean. This can be future space for a bonus room over time. It can be roughed to accommodate bedrooms and bathrooms. Or if you know what you're looking for, we can finish it for you in the course of construction. That about wraps it up for SeaSide. Let's go check out some finished models in Regency Lakes. Under the Darcy. We are now in Regency Lakes. This is the Darcy, the largest of our plans, 1690. Come on in. We began in this plan, if you remember back to the 1380 you saw on SeaSide, we're paying a lot of attention to bringing daylight through the plan for wide open views and connected spaces. This plan in particular has a very gracious family room. Back through the dining room to the kitchen. And in front of the kitchen, we have an away space. It can be used as a study, it can be used as a bedroom, it can be used as anything you want to use it as. There is an option as well. If this isn't large enough, there's an option to add an upstairs. Again, think back to the 1380. We had a staircase that came from the foyer to the second story. There's a way to add 1,650 or 1,680 feet upstairs on top of this plan. Regency Lakes offers a great opportunity for quiet relaxation and enjoying both indoors and outdoors. This 12-foot slider we stuck in. As standard, this opening is 8 foot wide by 8 foot tall. In this particular model, we've chosen to show a bigger door. This one's 12 feet wide for truly enjoying the unique setting for this home. Thank you very much for taking the time to join us on the Showhouse Showcase in both SeaSide and Regency Lakes. Come on down and visit.
It's 1 week left. The SeaSide model will be completed. Tune in next week to see the move-in process.